Hello, Paul Madden at the Yacht Channel here. This video is a reissue of a technical tour of the 172-foot ex-NOAA research ship Ocean Starr. And it is conducted by Dan Stabbert, who is the owner of the shipyard and the operator of the ship. And he's extremely knowledgeable, as you'll see in the video tour here, the technical tour. And the reason that we're reissuing it is that this vessel is now going to be auctioned off on October 1st. So check back, and there will be a video podcast on the auction leading up to it with more information. And then we're going to carry and broadcast the auction live on October 1st with cameras on board the boat. So bidders can talk to the captain or the owner who's on board the boat, and they'll have cameras and go around and explore the boat. And there's just a ton of other information that we'll be making available. So it's an exciting new initiative. And here is the technical tour.
NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, is the U.S. government's oldest scientific agency. NOAA's work reaches from the bottom of the sea to the surface of the sun.
172 foot in length. She's in a fine, fine research ship. She is on a year contract to the U.S. government right now, performing fisheries and ecological studies on the west coast of the United States. She's getting ready to depart for a one-month voyage out in the middle of the Pacific Ocean to study the debris, donut hole plastic issue that's resulting as a lot of the debris from around the Pacific Ocean is accumulating into one area they feel can be an ecological disaster. So she's going to go out and study that. There'll be about 25 to 30 people on board for the next month. She has a 9,000 mile range, and so that won't be an issue, but she'll be away from port services for well over a month, close to 35 days, with 30 people in the middle of the Pacific, so you need to take all your parts and spares with you. It's a very reliable ship. She's CPP propulsion and variable pitch. She can just cruise along at a half a knot, or you can do a solid 10 knots. She's very fuel efficient. She burns less than 800 gallons per day, which is for a 172 foot ship of this size and worldwide capabilities is very efficient, very quiet, very smooth running ship, and beautiful lines. One of the prettiest research ships in the world to date. Very expensive to rebuild to create a new asset like this, with a lot of fare and camber to the decks and fairing to the hull and the bow to the stern lines. It's a pretty ship. Large back deck area, which can be used for science work. It can be used for submarines, ROVs. And if you decided that you wanted a little bit less, it would be a great area for large lounges and so forth. The ship smells fresh. It smells like a ship getting ready to go to sea. It's got paint and, you know, the stores coming aboard and people preparing her, you can tell. And we carry marine mammal observers. We're always, you know, for some of our projects. And they use this area and then on top of the pod house for whale watching and protected species. Notations and making sure that we're integrating that data along with our fisheries and our ecological studies. Beautiful lines. I mean, gorgeous, gorgeous lines. Whether it's a research ship or a yacht or a combination vessel, you know, it's rare to have that feel. You feel how the bow flows down and the pilot house rounds out. It's a beautiful, beautiful vessel. And hydraulic-driven anchor winch. The chains are a little rusty now, but the vessel's in class, fully has a U.S. Coast Guard certification, which is rare, on top of it as a passenger vessel and research vessel. And then she also has ABS load lines and ABS class. So all her machinery is cared for and maintained to the highest standard. And many a mile, you know, many a, an ocean expedition has been witnessed and experienced from this location, standing right here, all over the world. Nice boat. This is a nice boat. We have this cherry flooring in here and all the electronics. She's set up for, you know, of course, if you convert her over to a yacht, this would be a beautiful, beautiful area for that. You could put a big settee area back in here, and you could turn this into a nice integrated pilot house lounge area here. They use this for navigation, for survey. Here's an integrated control and maintenance system. It monitors the generators and the automation of the machinery, generators, main engines. What a great area for a sky, you know, sun deck, and you know, with the bimini up here and looking down over the bow. We're above the pilot house here. Good height, great visibility. She's got life vests because she can carry up to 45 people on board. She meets passenger ship criteria for her number of life rafts that she carries port and starboard. Science cranes and science equipment, a number of hard bottom inflatable launches on here that are used. But primarily the A-frame is used for science, for deploying scientific tools, ROVs, AUVs over the stern. And then she has other various A-frames up that go off the side, the J-frames, the single-legged J-frames, and those are for deploying scientific instrumentation for water quality and current and salinity and coring devices and that type of thing off either side, port and starboard. Wet lab, for wet lab species and bringing fish and salinity samples and anything to do with anything that's wet and caustic aboard, set up for chemicals. This is where it's happening, the galley. She's about 25 to 30 people in this area, so that works well. Number of staterooms up here, four to the dining area, the galley, and the dining area. And then, of course, your bosun's locker and deck machine shop here. Being used right now, preparing. She leaves in just a few hours for this next mission, and has been at sea for about 5 months working and just came in a few days ago. And she leaves tomorrow, refuels and leaves tomorrow for that 35-day mission out in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. And then she'll come back and immediately go back on another mission for another 4 months. So, highly reliable vessel.
Yeah,
she carries, I think, 50,000 of fuel for 45 days, at least 45, 50 days. That's well over 12,000 miles, over 10,000. At 240 miles a day.
The main engine room, where you've got two main engines and then the two generators in the control space. The heart of the ship. She has multiple water makers, obviously twin screws, CPP propellers, three generators. So she can run on either one of these generators, and they're large capacity. But a lot of science, she so can support a lot of science and mission-related equipment. In class, she's load-lined in class with a certificate of inspection by the Coast Guard on top of it. It's a very thorough set of regulatory inspections. These ships are meant to go offshore long distance, you know, and carry out their mission.
And we look forward to seeing you on the next Yacht Channel podcast. Be sure to subscribe, and we will see you soon.